LBB, Carrollton, News Talk, 1330, FM 106.3.
And good morning. Welcome to Community Voice. I am your host, Josh Engel. Today's Thursday, May 28th, 8:30 a.m. Joining the studio today, we have Daniel Jackson, the CEO and president of the Carroll County Chamber of Commerce in Carroll tomorrow, as well as Rhyne Owenby, who is the director of member engagement and, well, the princess and many other things, actually, over at the chamber. So we were chatting prior to the show here, and we're very happy to have them. So we are going to be speaking a bit on, several initiatives that they currently have in place, as well as the trials that we, as a community, and of course the chamber, has had to endure during the recent pandemic. We'll call it Code Blue, though. We'll call it Code Blue just to avoid that. So why don't we just get right to it? Daniel, why don't you take it away? Talk to us a bit about the early days of the pandemic, the planning, the information sharing. I know that you guys have you guys kind of were thrust into that position.
We were indeed. We all were, weren't we? And so thank you, Josh, and Colin and Steve and all the team here. You guys have been an important piece of helping us get through this and communicating with our people. So we appreciate you guys, and thanks for letting us be here today. We want to focus more on what we're doing now and what we're going to do in the future. But to sort of lay the groundwork and the foundation, you and I were together, 9 weeks ago, maybe, and at that point, we didn't know what COVID was going to look like and how long it was going to last. And I remember saying, we're going to get through this. We've been through tough times before, but the reality that settled in, and it was there were some dark days, some dark weeks there. We're not going to deny that. And all of us, we weren't sure what we were getting into. And so it's been, I view it going through phases. And early on, you know, we were, what is this all about? And we're being overwhelmed with information. And then there was the dark time when the social distancing and shelter in place and all of that. And that was tough for all of us. And in the chamber world, we're relationship people, and we like to be together. And all of a sudden, we as staff are separated and having to do our work virtually, and everybody, our board and so forth. Anyway, we made up our mind 5 or 6 weeks ago, we will get over this at some point, and we need to start focusing on what are we going to do when things start to loosen up and open up. And as the chamber, we felt conflicted because we were trying to honor what leadership was saying, and that was, you know, social distance, shelter in place, there's no cure, we got to separate. And that's painful for chamber guys. You know, we want to be together, we want to grow business.
Yeah, so anyway, you're forced in a tight spot there.
You got it.
You're between what's doing best for preserving businesses and of preserving life during that tough time. You know,
you got it. But so now, you know, we're in a different phase, and that's what we want to focus on today, and thank you for the chance to share that. I've been telling folks the sunshine is brighter, the sky is getting bluer, and we're beginning to feel like a chamber again, and it feels good. And we still need to be cautious and careful and respectful for each other and what's going on, but there's better times that have begun and are going to continue, and that'll be our focus today. But I will say this, kudos to our community, our healthcare community, all of those on the front line, to our community leaders, elected officials, to our media, and just to our leadership in general. Everybody stepped up going through something we've never been through before, and they did their part, and that puts us in a position now to come out of this as a community in a much better place, I think. So, again, thank you for letting us share, and we look forward to sharing some good things now that are going to help drive us going forward.
Hey, I think everybody could use a little sunshine during this time. So I'm very well said. The sunshine is brighter and the skies are bluer. So, well, why don't we go over to Rhyne here. So why don't you talk a bit about some of the early efforts that the chamber sort of hit the ground running with when everything started getting a little weird.
Yeah, and we realized early on in the first week that that all this started, when we, in fact, Daniel and I were at a conference when the governor had his first press conference and the schools closed, and we were all together. We met in our boardroom, and we started calling that the war room, and we were all gathered in there using social distancing even in the early days, and realized then that we were going to have to start some programming early on to help the businesses in our community. And we started with the virtual tip jar. That started week one of this of the pandemic. We did the virtual tip jar. We started about buy now, shop local campaign where people could go through our website to buy gift cards from local merchants. And we continued with the Think Carol First campaign, which has been a shop local campaign that we've used for 5 years now. Through the virtual tip jar, people could go on to our website and donate money to local restaurants to donate to their, the restaurants could then donate to their wait staff. Last week we closed that down and were able to donate over $3,000 to local restaurants to give to their wait staff.
Yeah, so, when I spoke with you yesterday, you were in the midst of dropping off these big checks to these restaurants.
Yeah,
say,
yesterday
hey, hopefully this helps.
I was able to take a $500 check to Jefferson's, was just one of the ones. We're going tomorrow to Sunset Hills to donate $600 to Sunset Hills. In fact, there was a community, a neighborhood in our community that hosted a ice cream and cookie sale in their community. They used social distancing and did that and raised over $600 for Sunset Hills wait staff. So lots of great things. And I echo what Daniel said. Our community just came together in ways that were just amazing to watch. And so many businesses pivoted what they normally do, whether it was restaurants that started donating to frontline workers, some of our industry pivoted to start doing masks. The Burson Center and the Tinker's Box worked along with Tanner to use a 3D printer to do the face mask for Tanner workers. So our community did an amazing job of coming together in those very early days to do the things that were needed, especially when we thought there was going to be a shortage of PPE and things that were really needed to protect our healthcare workers. So it was a great place to be. And even what our school system did in talking to our school superintendents, and in less than 24 hours, our educators pivoted to be able to go to distance learning in 24 hours. I think that's amazing to see what our teachers and the even the folks that were and to make sure that those kids got meals. So we are in an amazing community, and I'm so blessed to be part of this community. So kudos to everybody who worked so hard. So those were the early days, and now we've got so many exciting things to talk about that are happening now, and we're going to be good. We're going to be fine.
Excellent. Well, you touched on briefly the buy now, shop local, and the gift card program. So these were all things that you guys had going on.
Yeah, and the although the virtual tip jar has closed down for now because most of the restaurants are up and running, whether it's curbside or delivery, and you can a lot of the dining rooms are open now. But the buy now, shop local is still available. You can go to our website and several of our local, and it's not just chamber members. It's local businesses that have e-cards and gift cards. You can go through our website, and they're on there that you can go in and buy gift cards and that type thing through our website. And we always do Think Carol First, so that is something that we will continue forever. We are the champions of shop local, so we will continue doing that as we move forward, and a lot of initiatives coming down the pike that you and I have talked about that we'll be able to announce next week. But that is Think Carol First is something that we will continue as we move forward.
Excellent. Well, we're going to take a quick break so we can get into the some of this exciting new initiatives that are coming out of the chamber. But when we come back, yeah, we're going to be talking about the Blue Ribbon Economic Recovery Task Force that the chamber has put together to help grow our economy and strengthen local business. That and along with many other things. But we'll get to that right after a quick word from our sponsors.
As we journey through this global pandemic together, Oak Mountain Academy is lifting everyone in prayer and holding the community in our hearts. We continue to pray for all of the families directly impacted and the first responders and medical personnel on the front lines. There are so many individuals working around the clock to keep us safe and healthy. I'm Patrick Uran, headmaster, asking you to join all of us on the mountain in prayer and gratitude for everyone in our community. For more information about the Academy, visit us at oakmountain.us.
For more than 70 years, you have turned to Tanner Health System for your healthcare needs. As our community moves forward, Tanner is here for you. Strong, safe, and close to home. Routine medical appointments, urgent elective surgeries, and imaging are back on the calendar at our hospitals and Tanner Medical Group practices. With the safety of our patients, staff, and community always our top priority. Learn more at Tanner.org. Hashtag We Are Tanner Strong. That's Tanner.org. Hashtag We Are Tanner Strong.
And good morning. Welcome back to Community Voice. I'm your host, Josh Engel. Today is Thursday, May 28th, 8:39 a.m. in the morning. We got Carroll County Chamber of Commerce in the house. You know who it is. It's Daniel Jackson, the CEO and president of the Chamber and Carroll Tomorrow, as well as Rhyne Owenby. They're both dear friends of mine. Well, she's the director of member engagement. I should throw that out there. They're both dear friends of mine, and they've been hard at work ever since the first murmurs of the coronavirus started popping up in the media and on the news, and the CDC was starting to give us warnings. They hit the ground running with several initiatives to try and preserve our economic stability and encourage economic recovery now that things are starting to slow up some. So why don't we just get back to Daniel here. So why don't we talk about Code Blue?
Sure. So, you know, being a glass half full kind of guy, I didn't underestimate COVID, but I didn't think it was going to be as long as it's been, the extended and the depth of it. You know, I just couldn't fathom that it could have that kind of impact on us. And so it became apparent early, we're going to have to take this thing seriously, and it's going to force us to change some things. And we did. Kudos to our staff. You know, there's only seven of us, but we were thrust into this and the focus of the entire team. It was also apparent we can't just deal with this ourselves. We're going to have to rely on resources in the community. So what we finally concluded ourselves is anything pertaining to our response to COVID, we're going to call it Code Blue. Certainly not being medical people, but watching TV, you know, the Code Blue and all the resources come in to respond to an emergency. So that was kind of how we viewed.
And let's be honest, everyone was tired of saying coronavirus and COVID-19. Exactly. I'm sick of saying
that. So that was our term for anything that pertains to that we're going to do now or going forward. We'll call that Code Blue. But beyond that, we need an overarching. We're going to have to change some things because our normal calendar was disrupted for 3 months. And even now, for most of us, as we're trying to plan out the second half of the year, there's still some question marks. We're having to read this thing. And so we concluded that we'll pivot, was the term that was used, and we'll say from the rest going forward, it's going to be Together Carroll. To do that, we said we're going to draw from our leadership. We have a chamber board, which is an outstanding group of folks. So we're going to deputize them as our recovery task force team, and we're going to partner them up with our own staff and with some other resources in the community. So we created this Blue Ribbon Economic Recovery Task Force, and we're beginning to unveil that, and we'll talk about that in a minute. We actually hired a consultant, which we've never ever done before, to help us look at this and have a fresh set of eyes and objective for us as staff. What do we do? What do we put on hold? What do we keep doing? What do we go virtual? That kind of thing. So these are some things that we were going through over the last 3, 4, 5 years, but it's becoming a little clearer now for us, and now we can share with you some things that we're doing now. There's energy, there's momentum. People seem to be pleased and excited about these possibilities, and again, as we begin to move about and open up, we want to do it in a responsible fashion, but we believe we've got to get back to life and work, and so that's what we're attempting to do in a responsible way.
Excellent. So let's talk more about this Blue Ribbon Economic Recovery Task Force.
Okay. So again, the entire chamber board, along with our staff and some others, have been assigned. We divided up the chamber membership into 23 sectors. And we felt like, you know, the impact is different if you're a restaurant, if you're an auto dealer, if you're media, if you're government. And so we felt like we can maybe be more responsive if we divide them up into sectors, and we assigned ourselves as staff, our executive committee, and our board to focus on those. And through surveys and other methods of communicating with them, we're trying to identify what are the challenges and the opportunities. And, you know, there's been some success stories. Not everybody, some people set records for sales amazingly through this. So anyway, that's our intent now, is to be a little more laser focused, dividing up our membership in these sectors, and what can we do to support all of those sectors as a staff, as a board, and as a community, really.
Excellent. If we could, let's move over to Rhyne here. Let's talk about economic recovery, Carroll Together.
Yeah, and just kind of piggybacking on what Daniel was talking about with the recovery task force, we felt like it was really important to be able to have a focus on these sectors so that we have the leadership in place as we go about trying to decide what it is they need, what are the resources, and as we look at the sectors, we sent out a 10-question survey last week, and we've already gotten results from that. And we found commonality across the 23 sectors, so we're able to look at the common goals, the common things that they need, and we are no longer right now able to provide the sunrise seminars and those type things that we've provided in the past where we're together in a group, so we're going to start doing webinars and video conferences and Zoom type things, so now we know what they need, so we can provide that. In fact, I was on a conversation yesterday with Susie McCorkle, who's our events coordinator, looking at things that we can do because we already know some of the top five things that we need to look at just a week into this that we know that our membership needs. So it's more of a really laser focused approach so that we know what they need. And we have in place with our board and our executive committee and leadership from our chamber members that we can reach out to these guys and say, hey, this is what we need. How can you provide this for our community? And I think what we're going to find is that we really are providing the tools that our membership needs. And then we want to look at providing resiliency programming so that should we ever have this happen to us again, we have the tools in place for our businesses to know what they need to do to pivot, whether it's to provide e-commerce training for small businesses that maybe did not have a website prior to this. Well, now that we'll be able to say, hey, you know, here's what you need to do to have the tools in place to have a website available should you, and it may not be a pandemic and I hope this never happens again, but should you get ill and you know, have to close your business for a few weeks, then you have the tools in place to be able to provide for your business to carry on in your absence. So there's a lot of things that we've learned from this that will help us be successful as we move forward and be able to help our businesses be resilient as we move forward. So we're really, really excited about this task force and what it can do for our community and for our business.
Well, excellent. And I wanted to just sort of clarify. Let's talk about how the program works and in regards to the blue bows that we're going to be, the Chambers is going to be helping businesses acquire. Tell us more about how the program works and who participates.
Sure. Everybody participates. We kind of backing up just a little bit, we in the very early days, we wanted to make sure that we were a resource for everyone in our community, not just chamber members. So we started with the Think Carol First Facebook page. So we want everybody to put blue bows on their businesses to show the community that you're open for business. Our chamber members were asking to send us photos of their blue bows on their business with their hours. Some people have got different hours that they, you know, they're a little bit different than they were originally. We're taking bows. Yesterday, I think I spent all day out delivering bows. Next week, we'll have a big basket of blue bows in our front lobby. You can stop by the chamber office to pick up a bow. We just want to cover our community in blue bows because in our mind, this is a blue ribbon community, and we want to fill it up with blue bows to let people know that we are open for business. You've got in front of you some signs that we have made that are available on our Facebook page and our website just to let remind people to open business safely. That is the number one priority, is that we remember to be safe as far as social distancing. Some businesses do require that you wear a mask when you're in their business. We have masks. I don't know. Daniel and I have our masks on.
Yes,
they're Think Carol First masks. We have those available. We've distributed those out to several, and I brought you some today as well.
And they're very nice masks, and you got the branding and everything.
Yes, and I have nice to give a mask. Shout out to Will Osier at Osier Apparel. Will made these for us in short order. We just want to be safe. We want to, you know, remind people to hand sanitizer, social distancing, that type thing, and to whatever the rules are in businesses, you know, in the business to be mindful of that, because we do want to be safe and to as part of the recovery effort, we want to make sure that we're doing that as well.
Well, perfect.
So that is the purpose with the blue bows, and I've seen blue blue bows everywhere. I'm so excited. So that was why we wanted to do that, just to as a symbol that we're open for business. Carroll County is open for business.
Well, I know that that Mr. Granick, we have the blue ribbon over at the front door at the Parkwood Studios, where a lot of our music stations mm-hmm. are, and we also have this sign. I'm not sure if the cameras can catch it, but yes, we are open. That is on the front of our door here, and actually, we can move this one around so you can see it. Yes, we are open. These are actually very effective to let people know that are passing by that you're open. And then if they want to know more about the hours and everything that's going on, you guys are going to be giving them a shout out. So before we go to another break, I wanted to ask. So let's say if there's a business owner that may not be familiar yet with this program and they're driving and they're hearing this, where can they find more information about this initiative?
They can call the chamber office. They can visit our website, or Facebook is probably the easiest place to find out. Visit our Facebook page at Carroll County Chamber. That would probably be the easiest place. We've got lots of information on there. There's some hang tags that we have published on our Facebook page. That's the easiest place to find it on Facebook.
Excellent. And yes, and these signs are available to be downloaded and printed off of the chamber website?
Yes.
Perfect. Excellent. Well, we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to chat more about some of the other programs that are coming up soon, as well as some more information that's going to be announced next week, but we can tease a little bit here, right here on Community Voice. So stick with us, and we'll be right back after a quick word from our sponsors.
For more than 70 years, you have turned to Tanner Health System for your healthcare needs. As our community moves forward, Tanner is here for you. Strong, safe, and close to home. Routine medical appointments, urgent elective surgeries, and imaging are back on the calendar at our hospitals and Tanner Medical Group practices. With the safety of our patients, staff, and community always our top priority. Learn more at Tanner.org. Hashtag We Are Tanner Strong. That's Tanner.org. Hashtag We Are Tanner Strong.
As we journey through this global pandemic together, Oak Mountain Academy is lifting everyone in prayer and holding the community in our hearts. We continue to pray for all of the families directly impacted and the first responders and medical personnel on the front lines. There are so many individuals working around the clock to keep us safe and healthy. I'm Patrick Uran, headmaster, asking you to join all of us on the mountain in prayer and gratitude for everyone in our community. For more information about the Academy, visit us at oakmountain.us.
And we're back. Welcome back to Community Voice. I'm your host, Josh Engel. It is Thursday, May 28th, 8:51 in the morning. We're chatting with the Carroll County Chamber of Commerce. We have the CEO and president of the Chamber and Carroll Tomorrow, Daniel Jackson, as well as Director of Member Engagement, Rhyne Owenby. We've been talking about the economic recovery campaigns that the Chamber has been hard at work on since day one of the COVID-19 pandemic, which we now will call Code Blue. Anything to not have to say COVID-19 again. So we during the Code Blue days, Daniel and and all the members of the chamber and the different task forces and the board, they all got together and they put together a few economic recovery initiatives, one of which, and one of the ones I'm most excited about, is the Blue Ribbon Community Initiative. Just to do a quick recap, actually, Rhyne, if you would give the listeners a quick recap about the Blue Ribbon Initiative.
Sure. We are asking members of the community, business owners, to put blue ribbons on their doors and when they're open, so that our community will know that the stores and businesses are open. It's just a quick way to know immediately that a business is open, and it's just a great way for our community. It's something that's happy and exciting, and a great way for us to say Carroll County is open for business. Think Carroll first. We're open. We're here. We're excited to be open safely.
Excellent. Excellent. Well, so yes, if you want more information about that, visit the Carroll website, the Carroll County Chamber of Commerce website. That's carroll-ga.org. Or check them out on Facebook. And you can also get some of these fancy signs here, the Yes, We Are Open signs, to mount on your door right under the blue ribbon. So everybody knows that you're open for business, and then come check you out. Daniel, I know that you guys have done just tons of surveys to try to come up with topics for webinars and to try to provide programming that would help businesses. Sure. I would love for you to speak to that.
Sure, okay. And, we talked about it earlier. All of a sudden, we had to totally change how we do business because, again, we're accustomed to coming to each other. And thank goodness there is technology now. And we've all learned a lot of lessons in using technology. But One of the resources we used was surveying our membership, since we were scattered and we couldn't physically be together. And at different junctures, the different surveys, we were trying to get different information from them. The third one, our focus was, we want to do webinars. We're going to move to webinars. And this was in the last 2, 3, 4 weeks. So asking our members, what are the things you want to know? And so those webinars, Tanner did one on how to reopen your business so that it's properly the facilities, the cleaning supplies, et cetera, et cetera. How do you lay out your facility for your own employees, for customers, clients, that kind of thing. Then we did one on those who receive the stimulus money, the PPP money. We had an accountant talking about if you receive that money, your responsibilities associated with that. And then the following day, there was one on telecommuting. So those kind of topics that our people were telling us, these are things we want to know. In this most recent survey, we will utilize that not just for webinars, but as we are working with these different sectors, if they say, I need help with marketing, advertising, how do I utilize social media in my business? Maybe I want to change my business model. Things change for me. Maybe it worked or didn't work, and those kind of things. So those are... We're utilizing the results of the survey to help us know what we think we can best do to meet the needs of our people. We've spent our time talking chamber. At one point, before we finish, I would like to share some good news in terms of economic development as well on the Carol Tomorrow side of the house. So you cue me up when you're ready for that.
Let's talk about it right now.
Okay. So, you know, obviously Carol Tomorrow is an important piece of what we do, and that's the bigger scale economic development for our community. Woven into that is a significant amount of focus on workforce development, which is obviously with the employer employees now and people being displaced and furloughed and all of that kind of thing, and leadership. So on that side of the house, here's some good news. One of our local industries bought additional land for future expansion. We closed last week. JR spent 2 weeks doing a request for information for a potential, give us a shot at a very big project. He showed a building last week to somebody from out of state or out of a different part of the state interested in coming into our community. So the reality is, even during these challenging times, we've still had activity. There are people interested in the community. Those who are here are looking to expand and making plans for that, and others are still interested in coming. We've spent time talking with our educational institutions, West Georgia Tech, University, Department of Labor. They actually were on a conference call with our Industry Leader Council. And as we talk about the industries and businesses ramping back up, bringing their employees back, the resources that are there for that, there's some people who are going to use this opportunity maybe to change jobs, change careers. And so we're trying to figure out ways that we can meet the needs of the business side of the house, but also for those employees looking for opportunities. So we did want to share that there's good news even in the midst of this on the economic development side, and it didn't get put on hold. And so that's very exciting. And now it's beginning to pick up even more. Also, you know that we own the Burson Center. And so our clients at the Burson Center are continued to stay active, and it's been available on a limited basis, but Caitlin is over there, and we're very excited about what's going on there. And there's a possibility out of this, some people may want to start a new business. So we're also talking about how can we meet the needs of those who are interested in firing up that new business at our incubator.
Excellent. Well, we only have about 2 minutes left. So are there any final words that we would want to get out to listeners and on behalf of the chamber?
I think we just want to encourage people to you know, get out and support local business and support the businesses here in Carroll County. And just to say to folks, we're paying attention, and we're here to support our businesses and our community as part of this community. We are looking toward the future. We're making plans for events and things coming in the late summer and fall. We've got things on the horizon. Josh and I are meeting next week to come up with some plans for the coming weeks that I think are going to be really, really exciting to support our businesses and the community. So we've got a lot of things. We started out the year great. We had some great programming as we started the year, and we're going to finish the year with some great programs, great support for our businesses, great support for our community, and we are proud to be part of this community and proud to support our businesses and our community. And I echo Daniel in thanking you guys for your support and on all that you've done for us. we are grateful to you. So it's going to be, we're going to be good. It's going to be good. And we've got a lot of great things to look forward to coming down the pike.
Perfect. Well, thank you both very much for joining us this morning. And if you want more information, go to carol-ga.org. Check out the Carol Chamber on Facebook. Thank you both for joining me.
Thank you, Josh.
Thank you for listening. We'll see you tomorrow. Okay.